These are dark days, I fear.
The North Grove must never be lost.
You're sending him to the war? The boy's done nothing wrong.
The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now.
I've decided to name you as my sentinel, Sir Roland.
I'm just worried about my family.
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family.
Are you willing to risk an alliance with the crown?
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion.
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Rashan.
We don't want Whitehill men within these walls.
You can be my highborn ward.
Ethan.
No! Don't let them take me!
My son.
Whoa, it's just me, Beska.
Took you long enough. Your ale's getting warm. Or warmer, I should say.
This stuff is weak compared to Northern Ale.
You can stop pacing. They'll be here soon.
Is that wine? Or blood?
Taste it and find out.
Blood.
This place could use a good cleaning. I complained to...
Beska, it is from us.
Nice having the place to ourselves, though.
Looks like we weren't the first to rough up the place. Fragrant.
Ale. It goes in yellow, comes out yellow. Waste time even drinking it, if you ask me.
Considering we found it in an abandoned tavern, it's not bad.
They smell off to you.
It's the only thing in Yunkai that doesn't.
I know. It's a filthy haven for thieves, murderers, and other deadly bastards. You should feel right at home. I know I do. May we drink, thieve, and fight until the end.
I'll drink to that.
You'll drink to anything.
Another round?
Have you forgotten about our honored and exalted guest? Go see if he's still breathing. How's he doing? We need him alive to collect his bounty. After that...
Remind me again, what's this fat pig fucker's name?
Bazak Zog... something or other. Don't care, really. So long as we get our gold. 800 gold dragons for capturing him. Lucky we caught him trying to flee Yunkai.
Lucky for us. Not so lucky for him.
We should find more former slave masters with bounties on their heads.
I don't need any more naked fat men in my life, thank you.
They say only the poor know how to really spend money. We'll buy the finest wines, the best whores. Sleep in a bed without fleas? Sounds nice, doesn't it?
We've not been paid yet, Beska. Can't spend dragons you don't have.
We'll have them soon enough. My point is, with enough coin we could do anything. Go anywhere.
I could afford passage back to Westeros. To Ironroth. I've heard nothing from my family in years.
You mean go home? They treated you like shit there. Kicked you out because you fell in love with a girl from the wrong damn house.
Gwyn.
A man doesn't choose who he loves. Your family should understand that. Westeros and its bloody houses. Who fucking cares?
They're still my family. My brothers and sisters. They had nothing to do with it.
I suppose that's true. Just remember, we have a good thing here. And any moment now, we're gonna be rich. Let's make a toast. To all of us deadly bastards.
To us.
Aye, to us.
Beska, I thought freed slaves put the bounty on Bezaak.
They did. With his own gold.
So why are the fucking Lost Legion here?
Oh, is that Tazal? From the Volantis job?
Maybe he's forgotten about that.
You! I told you if I saw you again...
Tazal! Isn't it funny how life brings old friends together?
Now cut your fucking throats!
It's good to see you too, Tazal.
Where is he?
Where's who?
Here. 400 dragons.
They must be working for the Wise Masters.
And that's all you're getting.
The bounty is 800.
You get 4. It's more than you deserve.
Give us 800 and you can have him.
Don't be an asshole now. We're all sellswords here.
We are nothing like you. The Lost Legion are the blood of all Valyria. And we are done taking orders from whimpering pigs.
Bloody hell!
And we're done with you, too.
La da diri, Zombazi. Do ebi me.
You just made a huge mistake, Tazal.
You two are going to be useful to me for once.
Not bloody likely.
The Wise Masters will hear how Asha Forrester kidnapped the venerable Bezaak. How he wouldn't take less than 800 gold dragons. So he killed Bezaak instead.
Me?
Luckily, we were there to deliver swift justice.
So you steal the money and we get the blame.
Ponte os en as! Porjos me nomi jahosso kisikas!
Alright, who dies first? Who wants to dance at the end of my sword?
Kill them! Now!
No one's more like it.
Here's one.
Come on! Sikuri no pass me! To be down.
You owe me one.
This is for Volantis!
Beska!
Fuck you, Ash.
Tazal!
Costa Vakitis!
Ash!
Will you burn your...
You know what this reminds me of?
That brothel in Norvos.
You kill me, and the Lost Legion won't stop until you and your friend are dead.
Asha!
In all the gods of fire and fuck!
Who the fuck is he?
My uncle.
That ended well.
More on their way.
We need to go. Come on.
Malcolm.
Damn them.
We have to keep moving.
Malcolm, stop.
Asher, I'm glad I found you, my boy. It's been far too long.
What are you doing here?
Your brother Ethan sent me. I'm here to bring you home.
That's far enough.
I come from the Tweens bearing the dead of House Forrester. Lordly tops from the looks of them.
All right, we'll take them.
Well, they're not free, are they? How much are you paying for them?
Sir Roiland.
You again. Have you got this time? Some poor peasant dressed up like a lord. A stable boy in bannerman's clothes. You did this at Duskendale. And you have the fucking stones to try it again.
No,
This house has suffered the loss of many good men. And you dare come here claiming to have Forrester dead.
They're Forrester. Look at...
Lee. Now.
Fine. I'll dump him in the river then.
You come back here again, you won't be leaving. You got that?
Aye, I heard you.
Lousy sheep fucker.
I'm sorry, sir.
Don't worry yourself.
7-0.
What is it, sir?
This one's still alive. You there? Who are you?
Roiland.
Roderick? Roderick! By the gods, it is you!
Sir?
Fetch the maester! Hurry!
Fetch the maester!
Roderick!
My lord, you should not be awake. The milk of the poppy. Drink. Calm now. That's it.
Roderick!
My lady!
I am at a very delicate moment in the surgery.
Please, I want to see my son.
How is he? Will he live?
Only if you let me finish my work. Sir, my lady, I must insist that you leave.
No. Roderick, what have they done to you?
These wounds would have killed any other man.
As it is, he may never walk again.
Roderick? What's wrong with him?
He drank the milk of the poppy.
Please don't leave me. Not yet.
That one before. It's nice.
Roderick, thank the gods. Brother, I thought I'd lost you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you.
Come here, sister.
How bad is it? Maester Tengrin says your leg may never fully heal. And your face.
I look half as bad as I feel.
Well, at least you look better than you did. Roderick, something you need to know. Ethan is dead.
Ethan?
Bruce Bolton's bastard came here and threatened to take me away. Ethan grabbed me. And that monster put a blade through his throat. Like it was nothing. Ethan? How could this happen to him?
We'll make Ramsay pay for what he did.
I promise.
Good. We're planning to honor Ethan in the Grove, alongside Father. And now Mother wants me to write this song for the funeral. I can't.
You can, Talia. I know you can.
It's been chaos here since he died. We have White Hill soldiers stationed in our courtyard. Even the small folk don't feel safe. You need to show everyone who this house belongs to.
They need a lord.
You're still a hero to them. If you lead, others will follow. I know you still need time to heal, but...
I'll be fine, Talia.
The council's meeting in the Great Hall right now, actually. Nobody expects you there, but if you think you're ready...
I want to go.
Can you even stand? They could use your leadership.
I guess we'll see.
I missed you, brother. You can do this, Roderick. I know you can. Roderick!
I'm fine. Why'd you do that?
I won't let anyone see you like this. Not when the house appears so weak already.
I need to attend that meeting.
And you will. But you will get there on your feet. It's a long way to the Great Hall. We can't risk you falling where others can see. Take my hand. Let me help you.
No. I have to do this on my own.
All right. You're really doing it. Everyone will be so glad to see you up, though I think you'll find that much has changed.
Castle Black, so this is the seat of the Night's Watch. The wall. Always wanted to see it, but not like this.
Is it?
Another one for Frostfinger.
On a horse, no less.
Looks like it was built by giants, doesn't it? You're new, here to take the black. Because you got that look about you.
I need to speak to the Lord Commander.
We don't have one right now. It's Frostfinger you want. He'll get you sorted out.
Which one's Frostfinger?
That grizzled old prune over there. Says us new recruits are all dead men. But don't let him scare you. That's just his way. You seem nice. That's not so good round here.
You're Frostfinger.
You recruits. You come, you train, you fight, you die. Who are you, boy?
I'm Garrod Tuttle, nephew to Duncan Tuttle, Castellan of Ironwrath.
Garrod Tuttle of Ironwrath? And how does a Castellan's nephew get himself sent to the wall? You're a thief, a raper. You abandon your post, or do you just fancy dying someplace cold?
I killed the men who murdered my family.
Then you know how to fight, at least. And you're no liar, either.
Sir?
From Duncan Tuttle, Castellan of House Forrester.
My uncle wrote to the Night's Watch.
He goes on for a bit, but then he asks us to make you a ranger. As if it's a knighthood. So you see, Tuttle, I know all about you. You are a killer. Even if you are man enough to own up to it.
You don't know me as well as you think.
I know enough. Now then, we'll start your training in the morning. For today, you need a cot and a cloak.
Understood.
Oh, and Tuttle, sooner or later, the Night's Watch will be your death. When it comes, try to make it quick.
And last we'd heard, Asher was in Slaver's Bay. So, Malcolm caught a ship headed for...
They give us month-old bread!
Ugh, there's fucking worms in it. And Lord Whitehill hears about this.
We should just take what we need. I'd rather die.
The Whitehill soldiers always seem to be angry, and we have too few men to handle them.
Let's just get to the Great Hall.
You know what else? No fucking wine.
Well, there must be wine in the cellars.
Degore's locked him up tight, just like his own cunt.
He has no...
Is that him?
Has to be, doesn't it?
He's hideous.
Had a run-in with Waldo Frey, did you?
I should have buried him with the corpses. Forrester's a
real
first.
Shame about your leg, my
Who gives a toss?
What?
We have business in the Great Hall.
Go round.
Get out of my way.
I'm quite comfortable, thank you. And I don't think you're gonna make me. I wonder what's weaker. Your legs? Or this house?
My men may be few, but they'll die before you keep me from my home.
Go on then,
my lord.
Let's go.
It's madness. You can't starve them
out. I will not coddle our enemies.
So you'd rather they riot?
Both of you, please.
If they riot, we'll fight.
That's foolishness.
It doesn't matter what you think. It's my decision as Sentinel.
My lords.
Roderick. My boy. Come, join us.
Lady Talia, you should have told us the Lord needed help.
My Lord!
Good to see you awake, Lord Roderick.
We didn't expect you so soon. The Maester said it would be weeks before you were walking, if you walked again at all.
It was highly probable.
I told you he'd be up and about.
I'm not here to talk about my elf.
Perhaps we should get started.
Yes, let's.
Dahlia's told me the state of our house.
Then you know our situation is grim.
No thanks to your sentinel. He's riling up the Whitehill soldiers.
They're our bloody enemies!
You'll bring Lord Whitehill down on us, you fool!
My lords, please!
Oh, I'm a fool. At least I was there by Ethan's side when Ramsay...
Sir Roland!
Ethan made it clear I wasn't wanted.
He needed you there. Now he's dead and Ryan's a hostage.
I am your lord.
Of course. Apologies, my lord.
The Whitehills have my brother. We fight amongst ourselves, and we should be fighting them.
We'd need an army to win that fight. And we don't have one.
Not anymore.
Then find me one, Sir Roiland.
That's no simple command, my lord. Most of our men fled after Lord Ethan was killed, and our allies are either dead or too afraid of the Boltons to help us.
You forget the Glenmores. You'd be wed to Elena Glenmore already, if not for the war. And her father is no coward. Now that you've returned, the marriage can proceed as planned.
The marriage?
Well, much has changed. The Glenmores may no longer desire the union.
Lady Elena will decide for herself. Your betrothed is on her way here as we speak.
Lady Elena?
She's coming now!
Why is she coming here?
She means to pay her respects to your father. But it could also be a chance to solidify our arrangement. If she still wishes to marry, we'd have the allies we so desperately need.
Their army would become oath-bound to Roderick.
And we could burn Highpoint to the fucking ground!
Yes, this marriage could be our chance.
Of course, we must hope Lady Elena still wants to marry Roderick. We're talking about a marriage, not an Ironwood contract.
I'm certain I can convince her.
She's always been fond of you.
Just be careful not to push Elena too hard.
If Elena does come to Ironwrath, she'll see those soldiers in the courtyard.
We starve them out, and they'll have to leave.
I'd rather they be lying around drunk than setting the stables on fire.
My lord, perhaps you could put an end to this tiresome dispute.
Give them wine. I want them dull, not angry.
Yes, my lord.
Now, if there's nothing more to discuss.
Maester, it's time to light the ironwood torches.
Yes, my lady.
Welcome back, my lord. It's good to be back.
Gregor last lit these torches when his mother passed. Ironwood doesn't burn easily, he told me. But foresters have a way. And now we light them for him and Ethan. How is your song coming?
Ethan always helped me with music. It's not the same without him.
You're a fine musician, Talia. You'll do a great job.
Everyone knows how much Ethan meant to you. I'm sure it will honor him well.
About Elena, I've sent a letter to Mira. The Tyrells hold much influence over the Glenmores. I don't know where things stand between her and Lady Marjorie, but maybe your sister can find a way to help.
It's entirely ridiculous. If it's not the flowers, it's the food or the table settings.
Is that the letter to the orphanage?
Yes, m'lady. It's nearly done.
Make sure to tell them we'll send all the leftovers. And something nice after that.
You and the children are ever in our thoughts.
A lovely sentiment, Mira. And the seal. Here you are. Oh, are there any more invitations to send, or are we finally done with the cursed things?
One more. An invitation to Sir Maynard.
Ah, yes. One of my father's favorite drinking companions.
I have a letter for Lady Mira Forrester.
Thank you.
My pleasure, Lady Mira.
What is it, Mira?
It's from my mother. She asks that I help ensure Roderick's betrothal to Elena Glenmore remain intact.
How can you do that from a thousand leagues away? Ah, it's my help she's after, isn't it? She's a bold woman. Most would shy away from asking such things.
Forgive my mother. She doesn't see the harm in what she does.
She's not entirely wrong. A letter from me could encourage the Glenmores to honor the betrothal. But it wouldn't be very discreet. You'd be forcing their hand. That isn't the way I do things. You pushed me before and you saw the results. I'm sure your brother can secure the marriage on his own. I'd better get going. Mira, we'll talk more later.
If Lady Marjorie wrote a letter... I'm sorry, Roderick. Sir Maynard, you are hereby invited... Mira, Lady Marjorie sent me to pick up the letters. Sir Maynard? The man's breath smells like a brew house. I was hoping I'd catch you at something slightly more exciting. A love letter, perhaps? Or a declaration of war? I know you're very busy with Lady Marjorie and all that's happening with your family. But I was hoping we could talk. If you don't mind.
What about?
Well, it's... We really should get these letters sent first. Do you need any help with those?
I've got them.
Keep getting colder. They say it'll be a short autumn.
Oi, fuckhead! You might be new here, but you're in my spot. So move.
I'm not moving.
Wrong fucking answer.
Most of you will be dead within the year.
Frostfinger and his bloody speeches.
If you want to survive in the Night's Watch, listen close.
You know why I got sent to the Wall?
The Wall was erected over 8,000 years ago.
And I don't care.
The realm from
you
the
should.
White walkers,
at this girl I used to fuck now and again. Face like a queen, tits like a whore. Turned out she was married to some lordling. He tried to stick me with this. I stuck it in him instead. So next time I say move, you'd best fucking move.
Shut up for once, will you?
What's your problem?
I'm sick of Finn bragging about all the girls he's fucked.
And what dire crime are you here for?
Fucking potatoes.
Potatoes? Potatoes?
What are you talking about? I stole them.
That's what got me sent to the Wall.
Nobody cares, thief.
Don't call me that. My name's Cutter.
Cutter the Potato Thief. There's one for the songs.
Oi, my sister was hungry.
I've got something for your sister.
Hey, don't fucking talk about my sister, all right?
Will you stop arguing?
Who in seven hells is talking back there? Tuttle. Who was it?
You're looking at the wrong recruit, sir.
So it was someone else, then? Not wise to point the finger at your new brothers, Tuttle. Garrod Tuttle here wants to be a ranger. So we can go north of the Wall and die on some wildling spear. But what he wants doesn't mean shit. So today you're all gonna show me what you're made of. Can you swing a sword? Shoot a bow? Are you strong? Those who do well might just survive. The rest of you.
Frostfinger. I need a word.
Go on, get started.
Best of luck, Tuttle.
Here we go. Again.
Bows up.
See those dummies? Those are Fens. Come to eat your brains for breakfast.
Gotta be faster.
Thank you.
You there, recruit. Scrawny, aren't you? See if you can carry one of these barrels over to the winch.
What's in it?
It's pitch. Dump it off the wall and it'll burn the wildlings down to their fucking bones.
Right. I can do this.
Want some help?
Hurt yourself, Tuttle.
I'm thinking steward for you.
You can help Frostfinger wash his cock.
Gotta be faster.
If the thing hasn't frozen off.
Fuck off, Finn. Bloody ass.
Mind your language, Garrod.
Not quite.
Grab a practice sword.
This one should do.
I'll be sparring with you today. Remember, these blades are dulled, but a sword's still a sword. Good luck. Come on, keep at it. Well fought.
Get off me, you bloody ox.
You got lucky.
Mansrader will shit himself when he sees you coming.
Let me show you.
Alright, let's see if you can aim worth a wildling's arse. Shoot the targets I tell you to. Let's start easy. Middle dummy, center of the chest. You can follow orders at least. Next bolt. Left target, head. Good. Right target, chest. Not bad. Center, between the eyes. One less wildling. You hit all of them. Nicely done. Again.
Finn thinks he's so bloody clever. If a real wildling got his hands on him...
Ah, he's just a bully.
Aye, he is. That's why I took this. Swiped it right off him. Don't tell, all right? I don't think he'd take it kindly.
I won't tell anyone.
I knew I could trust you.
You're pathetic.
Fuck off. You didn't even try.
A crossbow's a coward's weapon. Besides, I could hit that dummy from here with my... Where is it? Where the fuck's my knife? If someone has it, I'll cut their fucking balls off.
How the fuck should I know?
You were the last one I showed it to. Well, you and... It was you.
What?
You little fucking thief.
It weren't me.
Finn, don't.
Give me my knife.
I don't have it, I swear.
Out of my way.
Garrett, do something.
But stop it before someone...
I won't say it again.
Fuck!
Hey, look.
Fight! Fight!
Yeah, get him!
Here they go again.
Get off! What is going on here?
He stole my fucking knife!
No, I didn't.
And Garrett defended him.
The last thief I caught no longer has hands.
I swear I don't have it.
He must have hid it.
And you? I expected better, Tuttle. Instead, I find you doing this on your first bloody day of training.
Sir,
not another word. You clearly need a few days scrubbing the latrines.
Frostfinger, I need another man atop the wall.
Fine. Let him freeze his balls off. I'll deal with this one.
Get off!
Mind your fucking manners.
You, come with me.
This way. I love King's Landing in the afternoon. The sun just barely kisses your skin. You used to love this place. Remember, we'd come listen to the musicians in the evening with Lady Marjorie?
I have a lot on my mind lately.
Just through here.
What are you doing?
You'll see. Queen Cersei's finest wine. Come on, sit down.
You're going to get us both in trouble.
Relax. Nobody will miss it, I assure you. A little won't hurt. It's just wine. Suit yourself, then. So, I'm not very good at this sort of thing. Listen, if I tell you this, Mira, you must promise to keep it to yourself. You can tell no one. I want to trust you, but I need you to promise.
Sarah, just tell me.
All right. Fine. Just please, keep it a secret. My mother was a handmaiden to Lady Elena for many years. She became pregnant. It was a disgrace to her family. My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
Yes. I'm fortunate to be where I am, I know that. But to always have to hide. I don't want to hide from you as well.
Was your mother from a noble house? She must have been, to serve Lady Elena.
Yes, though it's not well known. Distant cousins of the Tywells, I'm told. They wanted nothing to do with me after my mother died.
How did you get this far? I mean...
I've been very lucky, I suppose. It's just... I don't want to be Sarah Flowers forever. I need Lady Marjorie to arrange a marriage for me. It's my chance at a life. A family of my own.
If there's anything I can do to help, just ask.
There is something. I know she often confides in you, and I was hoping that maybe... sometime when she comes to you wanting to talk, you might... suggest she talk to me instead. Give me a chance to win her over. Coming from you, it's sure to mean a lot. Please, Mira.
I can't make that promise, Sarah.
You could if you wanted. It's not that difficult.
You'll just have to find another way, Sarah.
I would, but... maybe you're right. I know your family's troubles are much greater than mine, with what happened to your brother and your father. You sure you won't have any? You look like you could use a drink.
A conspiracy of handmaidens.
Lord Tyrion.
My lord.
Ladies? What have we here? If you mean to drink from that flagon, you're going about it the wrong way.
We're just enjoying the sunshine.
Is that what they're calling wine these days? Not the finest Arbor Red, but a favorite of my sister's. Quite expensive for a handmaiden. I'd be curious to know how you got hold of it. Since I'm certain my sister didn't give it to you, she won't even share with me. Though that's hardly surprising.
We found it in that bush, Lord Tyrion.
Strange it should find its way into a bush. If Cersei knew you had this wine, she'd drown you in it. You must know what risks are worth taking, especially if you wish to have an alliance with me. Things have changed. My father has recently taken an interest in Ironwood. Most of the Royal Navy went up in green flames. It must be rebuilt. He insisted I handle things myself. I'm on my way to meet representatives of Lord Whitehill.
Lord Whitehill?
He's hired a pair of merchant lords to broker for his house. It would seem Lord Whitehill wishes to sell the Ironwood right out from beneath your family. I don't know much about the man, but judging by his up-jumped sellswords, negotiating with him won't be pleasant.
You can't trust Lord Whitehill.
I don't intend to. Come with me. These men think I have no choice but to deal with them. Imagine their surprise when I bring a forester to the table. It might be the first fun I've had in months. My lady.
We've been waiting here for an hour.
Andros, be courteous.
Courtesy in a merchant. Like finding gold in your chamber pot. Apologies, my lady.
Who is this? Some girl you've brought for entertainment?
She's a lady, Lord Andros.
My name is Mira Forrester.
Mira Forrester?
Why are you here?
A fair question.
We were told we would be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone. This is no place for a Forrester.
I'm here to sell our ironwood, my lord.
Oh, really?
Andros? I'm sorry, Lady Mira, but we've already spoken to Lord Tyrion.
You spoke, I listened. Lady Mira has since persuaded me to consider her offer first. Now, if you'll excuse us...
You're going to dismiss
us? You can't do this.
I assure you, I can.
This is a mistake, my lord.
I don't think so.
Lord Whitehill will hear of this. He's not a man to take such matters lightly. Nor am I.
That's enough, Andros.
There's no need to make threats.
You have no idea. Lord Tyrion.
Lord Tyrion, do let me know when you've come to a decision. I'd like the opportunity to change your mind. Lady Mira.
Good day, gentlemen. Ah, well, that was fun. Now, as for your offer, what did you have in mind?
My lord?
The Crown's Ironwood. I assume you have a proposition? You had a reason for coming here. I know it wasn't just to entertain me.
My family can supply all that the Crown needs.
You're suggesting the Foresters be our sole supplier of ironwood. Lord Whitehill will be left in the cold. If he wishes to sell to the Crown, he'll have to do so through your family. You'll have him at your mercy. Or you'll bring your houses to open war. You do know that's a possibility, don't you?
Then that's a risk I'll have to take.
I'll consider the arrangement. Of course, you'd have to do something for me in return. Don't worry. The terms will be fair.
What is it you want?
You'll know soon enough. We have an understanding, then.
Thank you, my lord.
This will either be very good for both of us, or very bad for you. For your sake, I hope it's the former.
My lady.
They were headed for the main gate.
I know another way.
You're coming with us, then?
If you're to save your house, you'll need more than the two of us at your side. You'll need an army.
That's why you're here, isn't it? To hire one.
An army of sellswords.
And a man to lead them. Do you hear what I'm saying, boy?
I can lead an army.
I know you can. I've always known it. Your father was blind to that.
None of that matters without sellswords to hire. And all the companies around here are engaged.
What about Croft?
One-Eyed Croft. with the Second Sons. They're all with the Targaryen girl now.
But Croft owes me a favor.
I'm pretty sure he hates you, actually.
No. He'll help us. I'll make sure of it.
And how are you going to do that? We didn't part on the best of terms.
I'll be charming.
Right.
Well, this mother of dragons and her sellswords are headed north, so we make for Meereen.
Wait, Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
We can't afford any distractions.
It's not your problem. It'll be fine. I promise.
It's fine. I trust you, Beska.
I shouldn't have said anything. I said I was with you, little brother. And I meant it.
Ponte Renas! Yunkai Hanonchos, Ibota con Costoti da Or!
Just one more we'll have to kill later.
Let's go.
You did well back there, Asher. You acted like a true leader.
You two can talk about it later. We need to get out of here. They won't stop looking for us.
It's a long journey to Meereen on foot. I hope you're ready, Asher. It won't be easy.
Just try to keep up, Uncle.
Don't you worry about me. Either we cross the Narrow Sea with an army at our backs, or House Forrester will not survive to see winter.
Everything's still here. The letters from my family. What would someone want with them? Was someone going through my books? Why would someone do this? I have information that will aid you with the imp. Meet me in the gardens at midnight.
There. That should last through Lady Elena's visit, at least.
There's been no news from Mira. She may not have found a way to help with Elena.
We'll be fine, Mother.
I pray you're right. Lord Glenmore's army could keep us from ruin. But Elena must still agree to the marriage.
My lord.
You might remind Lady Elena that in terms of lineage, you are still very much a man.
Maester.
What I mean is, if the two of you wanted to produce an heir...
I'll make sure she knows.
It cannot hurt. Most ladies her age.
Enough, Maester. Just remember that you'll want to see gentleness in you too. I don't mean to burden you with unwanted advice, but this is an important day for all of us.
Let me handle this, Mother.
You're right. I'm sorry.
My lord, she's here.
Roderick? You look... You're really...
Welcome to Ironwrath, Elena. It's good to see you.
Where are my courtesies? It's good to see you too.
Please.
So, here we are.
How have you been, Elena?
Oh, it's been quiet,
I suppose.
Times have certainly been difficult, but I'm well. Thank you for asking. I set out for Ironwrath as soon as I heard you were alive. My father suggested I wait, but I can't believe it's been 2 years.
Your brother's name day feast. We danced until the sun came out.
But now your house prepares for a funeral. And you... Tell me the truth, Roderick. How are you, really? And please, be honest with me. I don't mean to pry, but... I want to know what you're going through.
Honestly, I feel fine. I may not look pretty, but... I'm still myself.
I'm sure it's worse than that. I know you too well.
So much has changed since we were children. Playing hide-and-seek in the grove and...
You're so easy to find. You always hid behind the same tree.
Maybe I wanted you to find me. But Roderick... I need to ask you something. When I arrived at Ironwrath today, your courtyard was filled with drunken soldiers. White Hill soldiers. They said... some terrible things. The White Hills are your oldest enemies, Roderick. Why are they here? Has something happened?
We weren't given a choice. Those soldiers are here at the orders of the Boltons.
That's horrible. Roose Bolton must mean to occupy Ironwrath.
No, he just wants to assure our loyalty.
I'm going to be honest with you, Roderick. I have always looked forward to our marriage. But in light of all that's happened to your family... My father is questioning the wisdom of our betrothal. He wants me to call it off.
And what do you want?
I've been asking myself the same question. And frankly, I'm torn. I don't care about your scars, Roderick. I love the boy you were, and I can love the man you are. But my family can't get drawn into a war with the Boltons. They're the Wardens of the North. And they flay their enemies.
You and I can overcome anything.
I once thought so too. But I have to be practical.
Lena.
It doesn't matter how we feel. How can I ask my father to risk everything? Even for you.
Let's be practical. When we defeat the White Hills, I'll give your father half of our Ironwood Forest.
That's worth a fortune, Roderick.
We'll pay it to secure this alliance.
I'll need to discuss it with Father, but... Yes, I think this will convince him. Perhaps we'll remain allies after all.
Deepest apologies, my lord. I tried to stop him, but...
So, the rumors are true.
You have no right to just...
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore? You're not still marrying into this wretched family.
Our houses will be joined, in fact. And we will stand proudly beside them.
Can I change your mind? You can do much better than this cripple. And my son Griff needs a bride.
Get out. Now.
How rude of you. Your mother's the one who invited me here.
That's not true. I sent a raven to Lord Whitehill about letting Ryan attend the funeral. But I never expected him to barge in like this.
Oh, she practically begged me to come. Of course, I'd want the same in her position. The youngest son hung to mourn his dead father and brother.
Ryan belongs at that funeral. With his family.
Not until I'm certain that you know your place. Lord Ramsay ordered your family to obey my soldiers until my son Griff arrives from Harrenhal. But now I hear you're threatening them and keeping them dull on wine. It makes me start to question your obedience.
Lud, enough of this.
I do not have to obey.
See? That's just the kind of arrogance I'm talking about. Sure, here's the idea. We're going to make a fresh start, you and I. Your brother Ethan was a dismissive little shit. But you're a different man entirely, aren't you? So, if you want Ryan at that funeral... Sure, Lady Elena, you respect your betters. Kneel and kiss my shiny ring.
Just do it, Roderick.
You don't want to end up like your brother, do you?
I'm not kissing your ring. Do what you must.
Fine. I'll just tell Ryan you didn't want to see
him. No, please.
And because of your defiance, I'm taking what should have been mine in the first place. The other half of the Ironwood Forest.
You can't do
that! Snow,
I know what Ramsay said. I'm saying something else. As of today, I harvest Ironwood from wherever the fuck I please. And you can't do a bloody thing to stop me.
Careful, Whitehill. House Glenmore backs us.
And we're backed by the Boltons. So you'll be getting flayed together. Well, I have what I came for. I'll leave you to your business. Oh, by the way, my men have a name for you. Roderick the Ruined. Isn't that clever?
You'd put your pride ahead of your family. What's poor Ryan going to think? That we've abandoned him?
I couldn't kiss his ring in front of Elena.
She would have understood.
My lord,
Are you well?
I'm going to kill that man.
You can't be fighting with the other recruits. You need those men to have your back. There's enough out here trying to kill us without trouble amongst our own.
You're right. I'm sorry. I'm Garrett.
Frostfinger told me about you. Seems to think you might be trouble.
Might be right.
He said worse about me. He said you fought for the North with the Foresters. You were there at the Twins.
Yes.
I still don't understand. 3,000 men and not one could save my brother. Why didn't anyone fight back? Why didn't they rally to their king?
The men were too drunk to draw their swords. The Freys cut us open.
Those cowards. Couldn't face Rob like men, so they stabbed him in the back. They couldn't even give him an honourable death. Let him die fighting.
Walder Frey and Roose Bolton will pay for their treachery.
I'd like to believe you, but men like that don't get what they deserve. Now the Freys command River Run, and the Boltons are Wardens of the North. After what they did, it's not right.
They murdered my family. I should have been there.
I keep thinking if I'd been there, I could have done something. But chances are, I'd be dead too. Whatever I once thought, my place is here. With the Night's Watch. There are those here who will hate you for who you are. Southerners who will call you traitor. Northerners who will call you craven. Some won't even have a reason. They'll hate you anyway. You can't do anything about it. Trust me, I know.
I don't care if they hate me. Let them think what they like.
Ignoring them won't be as easy as you think. Most of the men are criminals, forced to take the black. You were a squire for a noble house. What happened to you today happened to me more times than I can count. I learned there's nothing more important than having brothers you trust.
Whoa.
I felt the same first time I saw it. I heard you want to be a ranger. Why? Why risk your life out there?
Winter is coming. I want to fight.
You'll have your chance, don't worry. Not many recruits want to be rangers. They'd rather stay here where they think they'll be warm and safe. But Mance Rayder marches on the wall with 100,000 wildlings. I've seen them for myself. The men here are murderers, thieves, rapers. You won't like most of them, and they won't like you. But they're your brothers now. Can you stand with them? Can you see past your differences?
If you ask me to, I will.
Glad to hear it. I'd say you'll get used to the cold, but you won't. Come on. Better get by a fire.
or you'll end up like Frostfinger.
I'm here, but where are you?
Where do you think you're going?
At this time of night?
I was just headed back to my room.
It's a little late to be out, isn't it? Do you know what this uniform means?
It means you serve the Lannisters.
So, you best get yourself back to your chambers. And I mean, now. If you don't like it, you can take it up with the Commander.
No. I'm staying out here.
Are you deaf?
At ease, Lucan. The lady is with me.
Yes, sir.
Enjoy your night.
I hope he wasn't bothering you, my lady. I'm Damien.
You were in the throne room earlier. What brings you to the gardens?
You do. You got my note.
That was you.
I'm very glad you could make it. I've been wanting to talk to you for quite some time.
Did you search my room? What were you looking for?
Nothing, Lady Mira. I only wish to leave you a note. I am sorry about this, Mira, but you've made enemies of the wrong people. A handmaiden should know her place.
What people?
I'll make this quick if that helps. I'd hate to see you suffer.
People.
So, someone sent him?
What are you doing here?
I heard yelling. You did what you had to do, Lady Mira. You had no choice.
I need to get back. Someone might see me.
I'll take care of him. I know a few places in Fleabottle. No one will ever find him.
We should talk about this. Later.
I'll find you.
Everything all right, sir? Damien, where are you?
What's Gwyn Whitehill doing here?
No idea.
Hello, Roderick. Sir Roiland. It's been a while since we've met.
Yes. Last time I saw you, you and my brother had almost started a war. Your father wanted to murder Asher for your little love affair, remember?
That was a long time ago. May we speak privately?
My lady?
Roderick, I came here because I know how hard these past few days must have been for you and your family. I know my words probably mean nothing to you, but they're all I have.
Don't pretend you know what this feels like.
We've all lost people, Roderick.
Some more than others.
Your brother didn't deserve this.
Neither of them did.
Listen. I know my father is intent on using Ryan as a hostage, but I think you deserve some news of him. I know it's little consolation, but if I can offer you this, it's something at least.
So you have news of Ryan?
Yes. He's well. Not happy, but just know your brother is safe at High Point. I'm looking after him, but...
What?
The other day he said something that made me worry. He asked me if his father died because he was a coward. He asked if he was really a thief and a traitor like my father says. I don't wish to upset you, but... I thought you should know.
Damn your father! How dare he fill Ryan's head with lies?
Calm yourself, Roderick. I've been doing my best to set him right. But he is only a child. He feels forgotten. Alone. He's waiting for his family, but every day my father tells him they will never come. That they've chosen their pride over him. And with each passing day, those words start to sound like truth.
I will get him back. He'll be with his family again. You tell him that.
Of course. But if you truly want to bring Ryan home, this war has to end. You know that. We don't have to be enemies, Roderick.
Hello, Gwyn.
It's good to see you, Talia. I hope I can count on your discretion.
Roderick, you should speak to Mother.
Mother, come join the others.
He should be here. He should be with his family, but instead they send her.
Gwyn came here on her own. She wanted us to know Ryan is okay.
It's happening all over again. I can see it. My father's house was once mighty like this one, but his loyalty to the Targaryens cost us dearly. I watched as countless of our kin fell, saw our land destroyed, everything we clung to was ripped from our hands. I can't watch that same fate before this family. Our house. My children.
Our family is strong, Mother. We will not fall.
Many men are strong, and still the night takes them. You must be ready to defend us, Roderick. Your body may be damaged, but your spirit must be like iron. You let nothing stand in your way, do you understand? If you have to murder every last Whitehill down to the babes in their beds, no matter what, you must do it. Promise me.
It won't come to that. We will defeat them.
War asks much of a man that he is not prepared to give. You must be ready. Promise me.
We will be ready, Mother. Mira, Asher, even Garrett. They all stand with us. We are strong.
Yes. I suppose we have to be.
Would you say a few words, my lord?
Father, he was everything. Everything I ever wanted to be.
He showed me what it is to be a lord.
He was so brave. I never knew a better man.
And I am sorry. I love you, Father. Ethan, my little brother. When I left, he was just a boy. But when his house needed him, he rose to the task, like a lord.
He would have been proud. We honor Lord Gregor Forrester, my husband, my love, and our Lord Ethan, my sweet little boy. But now is time to say goodbye. Father and son are returned to the earth, to the ice. And from their sacrifice, new life begins.
Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
From ice we foster's born, to ice we all return. Father, brother, I've sworn to guard this rest you've earned. I'd bear my neck to swim the shivering sea. Paint slaver's bay in crimson rains to bring Ethan back to me. Snow grabbed me from my mother's grasp to claim me as his prize.
Going on?
Roderick, you have to do something. Lord Whitehill's son has arrived.
Griff Whitehill means to torment us. Nothing worse than a fourthborn with something to prove.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof.
Form up and follow my lead. You'll be taking your vows. You too, Tuttle.
Time to start proving you're a brother.
Oh, the things we do for family. I wonder sometimes if it's worth it, all the sacrifices. Enjoy the wedding.
How much further to Marine?
A few days.
If the Lost Legion doesn't catch up to us first.
No.
I overheard a couple of men whispering about the Lannister Guard. They're questioning people. Is there anything else really to be worried about?
What was that?
From ice we forced us born, to ice we all return. Father, brother, I've sworn to guard this rest you've earned. May kings and queens melt down their crowns up high on Aegon's hill. In floods of gold I pray they drown, for all the blood they spill.
Old gods bear steel with you.